Hi everyone, myself Balasubramaniam, Assistant Professor in EC Department, St. Martin Engineering College. And my lecture is about, I'm going to explain about N-channel JFET working. Right, so N-channel JFET. So JFET, before going to start my topic, I want to give some clarity about the transistors. So first of all, transistor. So transistor. Transistor is a three-terminal electronic device which is mainly used in different amplification and switching applications in electronic circuits. So we can develop so many applications by using these transistors. So these transistors are basically classified into two types. First one is the bipolar junction transistor. Bipolar junction transistor, which is simply called as the BJT, and the second one is the field effect transistor. So further, these BJTs are classified into two types: NPN and PNP, depending on the construction of the BJT. So FET also classified into two types. So first one is the junction FET. And second one is the metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor, that is MOSFET. So JFETs are further classified into N-channel JFET and second one is the P-channel JFET. So coming to the MOSFET. So MOSFET further classified into D-MOSFET and E-MOSFET, that is depletion type of MOSFET and enhancement type of MOSFET. So further, D-MOSFET can be classified into N-channel and P-channel. In the same manner, E-MOSFET also classified into two types, that is N-channel and P-channel. So these are the total types of the transistors. In these, I am going to explain about the one of the field effect transistor, and which is N-channel JFET. Right? So coming to the N-channel JFET construction. So here I am going to construct the N-channel JFET. That is, for constructing the N-channel JFET, we need to consider a N-type of substrate. For this N-type of substrate, we need to diffuse a P-type of material like this. So this is a P-type of material, and here we can observe that it forms two junctions. That's why it is called as the junction FET, and it also forms three terminals. First one is the source, second one is the drain, and third one is the gate. So source, drain, gate. So these are the three terminals which consist of the N-channel JFET. So this is the construction of the JFET. Now I am going to explain about the working of the N-channel JFET. So working means, I am going to apply the external voltage to the N-channel JFET. So first of all, we need to consider case 1. In case 1, for example, this is N-type substrate and P-type of substrate, and a it is a source, drain and gate. So in between the drain and source, we apply a voltage source which is called as the VDS, drain to source voltage. And in between the gate and source, which is the input terminal, and input terminal we apply a VGS, that is gate to source voltage. So the here one thing we need to consider is the input section always reverse bias. We need to bias the input section such that it always in reverse bias. For example, if it is a p channel type, then it consists of a n type of junction here. So we need to connect the positive voltage here. If you see, it consists of a p type of terminal. For p type of terminal, I am applying the negative voltage. That is, I am making this junction as the reverse bias. Okay, so this is the main condition to operate the JFET. After that, first initial condition. So case one is nothing but I am making VDS is equal to 0 and VGS equal to 0. That is, both the voltages are, I'm making both the voltages 0 volts. I'm not applying any voltage. So if I am not applying any voltage, then there is no electron movement from source to drain and there is no current flows from the drain to source. Therefore, in this condition, drain current will become 0. So this is the first case. This is the first case. In the second case, so in the second case, so I am not changing VGS value, that is, I am fixing VGS as 0 volts and I am making VDS as some value. For example, I am applying VDS voltage. Right, so that is, in between the drain and source, I am applying a voltage. I am not applying any voltage at the input terminal. That is, VGS is make, I am making VGS as 0. So as we are applying the voltage between voltage source between the drain and source, so due to this voltage source, electrons entered into the source. Electrons entered into the source from the battery and moves towards the drain. So automatically conventional current direction is reverse to the flow of electrons. Therefore, current travels from drain to source, which is called as ID. That is, when if you are making the VGS as 0 and applying the VDS, then we get the drain current as ID maximum. We get the ID maximum. That is, in the second case, we get ID is equal to ID maximum. So this is the second case. So the third case, which is an important case here, in the second case I am fixing VDS voltage, that is a constant voltage I am applying in between the drain and source, and also a varying voltage at the gate to source terminal. That is, I am applying a negative voltage here for making this junction as reverse bias. That is, as I am increasing the reverse bias voltage here, as I am increasing the reverse bias voltage here, so if we observe here, this junction will act as a PN junction diode in reverse bias condition. We already know that in PN, if we connect the PN junction diode in reverse bias condition, the width of the depletion region will increase. This depletion region width will depends on the gate to source voltage. That is, if gate to source voltage, if you increase the gate to source voltage, this width increases. So as this width increases, the width of the channel reduces. So as the channel width of the channel reduces, number of electrons flowing from source to drain reduces. That is, electrons are reduces. Hence we can say that current also reduces. That is, drain to source current also reduces. So as we increase the gate to source voltage, this depletion region increases. At particular value, both this region will touch each other. After that, actually we consider it as a zero current, but practically we consider it as a constant current. Constant current. So simply we can say that as we increasing the gate to source voltage, the we are controlling the current between the drain to source. That is drain current is controlled by the input voltage. So simply we can say that as we are increasing the voltage at this terminal, the resistance of the channel also increasing. So that's why we call JFET as a voltage variable resistor also. One of the most useful application of the N channel JFET. So as we are increasing the gate to source voltage, the resistance of this particular region increases. So increase in resistance causes the decrease in current. So that's why it is called as a voltage variable resistor or voltage controllable resistor. So this is the third case. So from all these three cases, we can say that the conduction of the N-channel JFET depends upon the gate to source voltage applied at the input terminal. So coming to the characteristic curve. So first we need to consider output characteristics. So output characteristics. Output characteristic curves are drawn between the drain to source voltage and drain current. Okay, so right. So these are the actual curve, output characteristic curve of the N-channel JFET. This is also called as the drain characteristics. Drain characteristics of the N-channel JFET. So as we see here, so for example, here first I am considering the when I am making the VGS as 0. So initially I just make the VGS as 0. As I am increasing the drain to source voltage, that is VDS, I am increasing, current also increases. After particular value, this value become constant. So this particular point is called as pinch of voltage. Pinch of voltage. After this point, if we observe this, the current is constant. So that's why this region is called as the pinch of region. So as we increasing the VGS voltage, that is negative voltage, that is from 0 to minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, as we are increasing the gate to source voltage, we can observe that the maximum current values also reducing graphically. So this is the actual output characteristics of the drain characteristics of the N-channel JFET. So coming to the input characteristics. So next one is the input characteristics of N-channel JFET. So input characteristics are drawn between the VGS, minus VGS versus IB. So as we already observed in case 3, initially when VGS is 0, maximum current is flows. That is ID will be maximum, that is ID maximum. As I am increasing the negative voltage, that is minus VGS voltage, I am increasing the VGS voltage, then automatically the current value reduces. So this is the actual input characteristic of the curve of the n-channel JFET, which